The success rate for catheter ablation for atrial fibrillation is variable depending on the clinical circumstances. So there are two basic types of atrial fibrillation. One is paroxysmal atrial fibrillation. That means people who have episodes of atrial fibrillation that start, run for a bit, and then terminate on their own. The other is category is persistent chronic atrial fibrillation, where atrial fibrillation is initiated and then just continues. And in chronic atrial fibrillation, it may prove actually impossible to get the patient back into a normal rhythm by techniques using drug therapy or a procedure called an electrical cardioversion, where an electric shock is delivered across the chest under anesthesia. So in paroxysmal atrial fibrillation, which is an earlier phase of the disease, the success rate for an atrial fibrillation ablation is significantly higher. Reported success rates have been somewhere in the range of 70 to 80 or 85% for long-term success, and acute success rates even higher. For chronic atrial fibrillation, the success rate for catheter ablation is more in the range of 50 to 70%. And in the worst of circumstances, where there's anatomic evidence of significant atrial electrical disease, the success rate for catheter ablation for chronic atrial fibrillation is below 50%.